still to come. From 8, Zane Lowe. At 7, Annie Nightingale. Right now, the best of the official chart.
BBC Radio 1. The UK Top 40.
Hello, this is Greg James, the current gatekeeper of the official charts on BBC Radio 1 and your host for today's Radio 1 Vintage Chart Show. Over the next hour, I'm going to be looking back at some of the most historical moments on Radio 1's chart show in its various incarnations since it began 50 years ago. I'll be picking out memorable chart battles, charity singles, chart bloopers and the biggest number ones. Plus, there'll be a very special chart rundown at the end of the show with the longest-serving chart show DJ ever, Mark Goodyear. Let's get some music on first, though, and we head back to 1967 for the number wonderful sound in the Radio 1 Fun 30 on this day 50 years ago. This is Engelbert Humperdinck with The Last Waltz on the nation's favourite.
I wonder, should I go or should I stay? The band had only one more song to play. And then I saw you out the corner of my eye. A little girl alone and so shy. I had the last waltz with you. Too lonely people together. The last one should last forever. But the love we had was going strong. And through the good and bad we'd get along. And then the flame of love died in your eyes. My heart was broken too when you said goodbye. I had the last waltz with you. Two lonely people together. I fell in love with you. The last one should last forever. It's all over now. Nothing left to say. Just my tears and the orchestra playing. La 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 la. La 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 la. Forever. La 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 la.
That's the first ever number one played on Radio 1, and it would have been played by broadcasting legend Alan Fluff Freeman, who presented the chart, or Pick of the Pops as it was known, until 1972. Not off.
Greetings, poppickers.
And over here, from last week's number five down to this week's number six for Engelbert Humperdinck's Release Me.
I think my favourite chart show host has got to be Alan Freeman. Alan had this wonderful technique of saying nothing. He would, and right now it's gone to, and then he'd play a bit of music. And I thought that was genius. Also, his chart rundown, his timing and everything, which he did live as well, And I know that one or two people tried to put him off by talking to him in the headphones. I thought it was awful to do the thing like that. But he never, ever, I don't think, messed it up.
Tony Blackburn there talking about Alan Freeman. Tony went on to do the official chart himself in 1979 for 3 years. But one of the chart legends when I was a kid was this man, Bruno Brooks.
Love Hurts, down to a 28 on the official countdown. This is Bruno. Stand by for another new entry. That's next.
You know, I used to listen to the Top 40 every Sunday with Tony and other people that did it at the time. And when I was asked to present the Top 40, I think, again, it was originally just a stand-in. But I thought I'd never be doing this. And this is exactly what I wanted to do, because very much me. You know, I like energy and radio, and the Top 40 for me is all about energy, excitement, and yeah, and that became, I suppose, one of the biggest shows I ever presented on Radio 1.
And the man that took over from Bruno in 1995 would go on to be Radio 1's longest serving chart presenter, Mark Goodyear.
And this is Mark Goodyear at Radio 1. Welcome to the world's fastest and the UK's favourite chart. Exclusively compiled by Gallup for the BBC, it's the official chart. The chart the fans and the stars tune to. Today we'll discover if Bryan Adams will remain at number one or if somebody else will top the chart. Here come the hits.
What's really interesting about the Bryan Adams record is it polarises people. But you mustn't make the mistake of thinking that Bryan Adams might be tired of it. I mean, he thinks it's like one of his most important, best ever songs. He's incredibly proud of it. So I think we got a little bit jaded in the media and in radio by this record being around for so long. But it, you know, it just would not have been able to stay at that position if people weren't buying it. It was, that whole thing was led by the audience. It was led by the public. And this is why people in radio have to be a little bit careful, because we tire of records sometimes before the public do. And I was very mindful of that on the chart, although, you know, a whole quarter of the year and more, same record at number one. I think it became less exciting towards the very end.
Here it is then, 16 weeks at number one, the longest run in chart history for Bryan Adams and Everything I Do.
Look into my eyes. Trying.
Bryan Adams with Everything I Do, which first charted back in 1991 thanks to the big summer blockbuster Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
After 16 weeks at the top, Bryan Adams is down 3 at number 4. The UK's brand new number 1, straight into the top of the charts, The Fly by U2.
16 consecutive weeks is still a chart record to this day. That song sold 15 million copies worldwide. He's nearly been matched twice, though, over the years. Most recently in 2016, Drake's second UK number one, One Dance, managed 15 consecutive weeks at the top of the chart.
I need a one dance, got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go, higher powers taking a hold on me.
And this was only 18 months ago. And boy, do we all remember it well. Let's go further back to 1994 and Wet 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 released Love Is All Around.
There's no beginning, there'll be no end. Cause on my love, you can't depend.
Now that might have beaten Bryan Adams' record for consecutive weeks at the top had the band not got bored of their own song and deleted it from sale. But to be honest, I think it did everyone a favour.
Carry Endless Love and last week's number one, this week's two, Wet Wet Wet, Love Is All Around, which means it's a brand new number one for Wakefield. Saturday night is new.
The UK Top 41 FM.
Didi na na na.
Saturday night on BBC Radio 1 Vintage. 4 weeks at number one in 1994, thanks to Wet Wet Wet, who famously got tired of their own record. So both the success of Wet 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 and Bryan Adams can be attributed to their association with film soundtracks, but there are a whole range of other things that can drive a song to number one. Time and again, we've seen songs grab the top spot as a result of a public figure, usually loved, passing away unexpectedly. Long before Radio 1 started, the first deceased artist to top the charts was Buddy Holly in 1959.
There you go, invited. Here
dear, am I? Oh, well, you left me here so I could sit and cry. Well, golly gee, what have you done to me? Oh, well, I guess it doesn't matter anymore.
Fast forward to 1977 and to the death of Elvis Presley. He climbed to the number one spot with Way Down, which was already in the charts at the time. Then there was John Lennon. His murder in December in 1980 prompted the re-release of the iconic Imagine. That went straight to number one in January 1981.
Here's the top three. At number three, Jenna Louise, Stop the Cavalry. At two, it's John Lennon, Happy Christmas, War is Over. A brand new number one, John Lennon, Imagine. There it is. That's this week's top 20.
Imagine all.
But it was the death of a princess that resulted in the best-selling single of all time. Here's Mark Goodyear reading the chart on the 21st of September, 1997.
Down to number three from one last week, The Verve with The Drugs Don't Work. Second highest new entry at two, George Michael, You Have Been Loved. And now, on Radio 1, the first official confirmation of the most exciting and significant number one of 1997. And in the history of pop music in the UK, the fastest-selling single ever. Over 650,000 copies, all sold yesterday. Elton John, Candle in the Wind, 97. A tribute to Diana, Princess of Wales.
Goodbye, England's rose. May you ever grow in our hearts. You were the grace that placed itself where lives were torn apart. You called out to our country and you whispered to those in pain. Now you belong to heaven and the stars spell out your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never fading with the sunset when the rain set in. And your footsteps will always fall here along England's greenest hills. Your candles burned out long before your legend ever will. Loveliness we've lost, these empty days without your smile. This torch we'll always carry for our nation's golden child. Even though we try, the truth brings us to tears. All our words cannot express the joy you brought us through the years. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never fading with the sunset when rain set in. We'll always fall here along England's greenest hills. Your candles burned out long before your legend ever will. Than you'll ever sit when the rain set in, and your footsteps will always fall here along England's greenest hills. Your candles burned out long before your legend ever grew. Your footsteps will always fall here along England's greenest hills. Your candles burned out long before.
That's Candle in the Wind, 1997, which was a double A-side with Something About the Way You Look Tonight, which would go on to sell 33 million copies worldwide and is far and away the biggest number one in UK chart history. Now, it wouldn't be the chart show without an epic chart battle or two. And over the years, there have been both iconic and controversial ones. You can go back to the likes of The Beatles versus Engelbert Humperdinck in 1967. The Sex Pistols versus Rod Stewart in 1977. Wham versus Frankie Goes to Hollywood in 1984. And context, and to remind you that a reigning X Factor champion had got to number one at Christmas for the previous 4 years running, and it led to this battle.
So then, this is where we're about to find out what's going to happen for Christmas number one this year. First of all, let's have a look at what happened this week.
There's a truly epic contest this weekend. Joe X Factor McKeldry fights for the title of Christmas number one 2009 versus Rage Against I Won't Do What You Tell Me, The Machine. Round one, Tuesday, is the beginning of the week, and Rage Anti-Establishment The Machine leads Joe X Factor McKeldry by nearly 6,000 single sales. Hold on to your hats, ladies and gentlemen. We're in for one heck of a fight.
But I think that people are just fed up by, you know, being spoon-fed some overblown sugary ballad. Like I said, a little dose of anarchy for the holidays is good for the soul.
Round two, Wednesday. And oh look, Rage Against The Machine have increased their lead once again. Now the 66,000 sales set the two. How will Joe the Geordie ever manage to catch up?
Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose.
Round three, Thursday, and Joe has turned a corner. The machine's lead on the young man has decreased to a mere 37,000. He's got his eye on the prize and he's closing in.
I think it's the same as any other chart battle. It happens all the time, and I just hope that people go out and buy the single.
Round four, Friday, nearly a week on, and the campaign is showing no sign of slowing down. Rage's lead is now only 9,000. Tired and weary, but with gritty determination, the two opponents continue to battle. The Goliath that is Rage is now a target for the plucky young Joe, and the battle rages on. Will he find the mettle to turn things around in the next round?
Let's find out. Who is this week's number two on the official chart 2009 for Christmas?
Two.
It's Joe.
I can almost see that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it.
Now, I loved all this. As a radio nerd, as a chart nerd, just as a music fan, I thought this is great. This is exactly what the chart should be about. It was the proper national talking point. But for possibly the most defining of chart battles for UK pop music, we go back to 1995. It was the era of Britpop, a music and cultural phenomenon that emphasised Britishness. Southern boys Blur and Country House took on the northern swagger of Oasis with their song Roll With It.
Radio 1's original
original Top 40 chart show with congratulations to Oasis. They debut at number two. It's been the most talked about week in British pop music for many, many years. And the champagne corks are now going to be popping in London because we congratulate Blur. They're straight into the top with Country House.
Successful fella thought to himself, oops, I've got a lot of money. Caught in a rat race terminally. I'm a professional cynic, but my heart's not in it. I'm paying the price of living life at the limit. Caught up in the centuries, anxiety. Yes, it plays on him. Lives in a house, very big house in the country. Watching afternoon repeats in the food he ate. He takes a manner of pills and piles up analyst bills in the country. Oh, it's like an animal farm, that's a rural charm in the country. He's got morning glory and life's a different story. Everything's going jack and jory. In touch with his own mortality. He's reading balls and looking bad prose. It's a helping hand. Blind. Oh, it's a century's remedy. But the pain that haunts Star drives simple. Lives in a house, a very big house in the country. He's got a fog in his chest, so he needs a lot of rest in the country. He doesn't drink, smoke, laugh, takes herbal baths in the country. Says she comes to no harm on the animal farm in the country. In the country, in the country.
Congratulations to Blur, who've won the most talked about race of the number one slot in the history of the chart, pretty much. Country House straight in the top. And congratulations, of course, to Oasis, straight in at two with Roll With It, because if there's one thing this week's chart proves, it's that British pop is still the best in the world.
There you go. That was Blur's first ever number one single, winning the chart battle with 270,000 sales compared to Oasis's 220,000. And the champagne corks were popping in London. On to charity singles now, and there have been some huge chart hits supporting amazing causes since the chart began. Most recently, after the tragic events that unfolded in June this year at Grenfell Tower in London, a number of music stars joined together as the Artists for Grenfell and released Bridge Over Troubled Water. The song went straight to number one on the official chart after the biggest opening day sales in a decade. Artists featured included Stormzy, Leona Lewis' single of them all. Bob Geldof and Midge Ure got together and created Band Aid to raise money for anti-famine efforts in Ethiopia with the song Do They Know It's Christmas. The likes of U2, George Michael, Spandau Ballet and Phil Collins joined them to record the song at Psalm West Studios in Notting Hill. It was released in the UK 4 days later. It sold 1.25 million copies in 1 week, the fastest selling single ever. Britain's brand new number one, Band Aid. Do they know it's Christmas time?
It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time, we let
it. At the time, it was the best selling single ever, and it wasn't the last we heard from Band Aid. Over the years, Bob and Midge brought us three more incarnations of the original song, each time featuring a different collaboration of stars at the time. In 1989, it was the likes of Lisa Stansfield, Bananarama, Kylie Minogue and Cliff Richard, who spent 3 weeks at number one with their version of the track. There was Band Aid 20 in 2004, featuring Busted, Lamar, The Sugar Babes and Chris Martin. They spent 4 weeks at the top. And in 2014, Band Aid 30 was announced to aid Ebola victims in Western Africa. Sam Smith, Ed Sheeran and Rita Ora were amongst the host of artists who got to number one with their rendition of the famous song. An incredible impact made by Band Aid around the globe for over 30 years. And the chart was there to track it every step of the way. Let's turn our attention now to Ferry Aid.
Go straight in for Ferry Aid.
In 1987, the Zeebrugge ferry disaster inspired the likes of Paul McCartney, Boy George, Kate Bush and George Michael to release a version of the Beatles classic, Let It Be. All proceeds went to a charity set up to assist the families of the 193 people that lost their lives when the ferry capsized off the coast of Belgium. The song went to number one on the 4th of April that year, spending 3 weeks at the top.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my eyes,
let it be. It's me, Annie Nightingale, with the Annie Nightingale Request Show, as it was known. I'll see you in about 20 minutes.
You've got a friend, the happy sound of Radio 1. Vintage.
This is Greg James, and that was the radio edit of Rage Against the Machine's Killing in the Name on the Radio 1 Vintage Chart Show. If we head back to February the 21st, 1993, though, legendary chart show host Bruno Brooks accidentally played the full uncensored version of the song live on air.
Every expletive is out on the national airwaves. Broadcasting house reception, we're getting hundreds of calls. And I was the only person in the UK who didn't know about it.
Rage Against the Machine, Killing in the Name, is in at
number 27.
The Machine, Killing in the Name. That's a new entry at 27.
Now, it would hardly be fair to include everyone else's bloopers when I have an awful one which probably should be documented as well. And it's the time when I accidentally read the wrong chart out. It's not my finest moment. No, lots of things are going wrong today.
They are.
Not only news, but the chart went wrong.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
It's all going off.
Now, Reg and Chris Smith, I've got a confession to make. The rundown, which we did about 5 minutes ago, was in fact a rundown from 4 weeks ago, and the wrong one went out on there. Oh, let's move on from that. For our final blooper, it's time for a trip back to 1982 and the legendary Tony Blackburn's mispronunciation of the name of a brand new band from Birmingham.
Straight in the Radio 1 Top 40, position number 26. That's a new entry, Duran Duran and another called Planet Earth. Radio 1, Britain's favourite. Thank you very much for a couple of people who rang up and I didn't realise that I said it, but I mispronounced the name. I said Duran Duran and Planet Earth at number 26, when of course it should be, as everybody knows, Duran Duran. When you're doing a tight scheduled process, sometimes you mispronounce things. I do apologise. None of us are too big to apologise. Sorry about that. Duran Duran, of course. Thank you very much for taking the trouble.
The thing I remember more than anything else with the top 40 was my mispronunciation of Duran Duran. They were new and I called them Duran Duran. And if you look at the way it's spelled, it is Duran Duran. It's not Duran Duran. But then somebody rang me up and said, oh, you know, you said Duran Duran. I said, so what? They said, it's not Duran Duran, it's Duran Duran. And I've lived with that ever since.
And I suppose we should probably play it. So, with Planet Earth, it's Duran Duran.
Thank you.
Duran Duran and Planet Earth on BBC Radio 1 Vintage. And what a show it's been so far, looking back at some of history's biggest chart moments. And to wrap things up, I'm so excited to say that I'm joined by an incredibly special guest, a radio icon, a radio hero of mine, Mr. Mark Goodyear.
Very good to see you.
Oh, it's so good to have you on, Mark. And people will know you who listen to Radio 1 Vintage as the man who did the chart show for 10 years. You started in Radio 1 in 1987.
Yes, Boxing Day 87, so nervous was I could not eat my Christmas dinner the day before.
I think that's a mean day to make you start your Radio 1 career.
It was just what it was. You just take the chance, and I managed to cling on for a few years.
What are your memories of Radio 1? What are your favourite memories?
Well, I remember, like a lot of people who love Radio 1 now, it's part of your fabric of your life as you're growing up. So my heroes were people like Johnny Walker and John Peel and Stuart Henry, those names that you've heard a lot over the course of this weekend on Radio 1. And so my memory is of being like the apprentice. You maybe remember this when you started here. You come in and it's so important to you, but these people around here are giants. So I was really, you know, I was humbled by the experience, and it took me really quite a long time to find my feet. But I'd always been a fan of pop music, and I've always been a fan of the chart. Used to love Tom Brown and all my predecessors on this. So I felt it was a kind of a badge of honour and something I really had to live up to.
I relate to that very much, yeah. Feeling overwhelmed when you join the place that you listen to.
Yeah.
Shall we do a rundown?
We're going to do the 40.
Shall we do the current 40,
yeah.
from the week just gone on Radio 1?
Before you do that, would you have a little bash at introing the chart like I used to have to? Because you've got the jingles there.
Okay, fine. So it's pretty quick, isn't it? It's got to be quicker than I usually do it.
No, you could meet you in the middle, okay?
Okay, here we go.
The complete UK Top 40 countdown.
Hi, good afternoon. This is Greg James at Radio 1. Welcome to the world's fastest and the UK's favourite chart, exclusively compiled by the official charts company for the BBC. It's the official chart, the chart that the fans and the stars tune to. Today, we'll discover if Sam Smith will remain at number one for a third week, or has somebody else got the top of the chart? Here come the hits.
Very good.
Critique?
Yeah, I'll give you 8 out of 10 for that. You'll get 10 next week. Now we've got to meet in the middle and do this chart rundown. This week's chart.
This is going to be tough. Should we go?
Yeah.
The complete UK Top 40 countdown.
And we start at 40, down 1 for XXXTentacion with Jocelyn Flores.
39, down 15, Niall Horan and Too Much to Ask.
Down 4, it's Ed Sheeran at 38 with Shape of You.
New entry, 37, Cardi B and Bodak Yellow.
New entry for Paloma Faith at 36 with Cry Baby.
A climber at 35, congratulations, Post Malone and Quavo.
It's a re-entry for Ed Sheeran with Perfect at 34.
Falling 6 at 33, Feels, Harris, Pharrell, Big Sean and Perry.
And it's down 2 at 32 for EXO Tour Life, Lil Uzi Vert.
And at 31, Jason Derulo climbing 2 with If I'm Lucky.
And into the 30 we go with a new entry from Big Shaq. This is Man's Not Hot.
At number 29, Finders Keepers, Mabel featuring Kojo Funds. That's a new entry.
It's up 7 for Craig David at 28 with Heartline.
27, it's Taylor Swift, down 6 and Ready for It.
Up 3 for Marshmello featuring Khalid, Silence at 26.
25, Despacito, Louis Fons, Daddy Yankee and Bieber falling 2 places.
It's Unforgettable at 24 by French Montana and Swae Lee. It's up 2.
Up 8 places to 23, Glorious, Macklemore and Skylar Grey.
Down 3 for The Script, Rain at 22.
And down 3 at 21 for your song, Rita Ora.
And into the 20 with Louis Tomlinson, down 4 places, back to you.
19, Swish Swish, Katy Perry and Nicki Minaj, that's climbing 3 places.
18, it's Maroon 5 featuring SZA, up 7 for What Lovers Do.
Falling 2, Demi Lovato, number 17, Sorry Not Sorry.
Down 2 for Mi Gente, J Balvin and Willie William at 16.
Chris Brown, 15, Questions, down 3.
Up 6 for Steph London, Hurting Me at 14.
Young Bane and Young'un, Bestie, that's number 13, it's a non-mover this week.
It's up 5 for Logic and Alessia Cara with 1-800.
And at number 11, Friends, Justin Bieber and Blood Pop, down 3.
Radio 1.
And here comes the UK's official top 10 at 10, up one for James Hype featuring Kelly Lee, More Than Friends.
At number 9, down 5, Taylor Swift and Look What You Made Me Do.
It's up 2 for Avicii featuring Rita Ora, Lonely Together.
At number 7, Dust Till Dawn, Zayn featuring Sia, also climbing 2 places.
It's down 3 for What About Us by Pink at 6.
CNCO Little Mix, Reggaeton Lento, that's down 1 at number 5.
Up 3 places for Havana, Camila Cabello featuring Young Thug at 4.
Number 3, down 1 place, Dua Lipa, New Rules.
And it's up 3 for Post Malone featuring 21 Savage with Rockstar.
And that means the UK's official Radio 1 number 1 for a third consecutive week is Too Good at Goodbyes, Sam Smith.
The UK Top 40, the UK's number 1.
You must think that I'm stupid. You must think that I'm a fool. You must think that I'm new to this, but I have seen this all before. I'm never gonna let you close to me, even though you mean the most to me, 'cause every time I open up it hurts. So I'm never gonna get too close to you, even when I mean the most to you, in case you go and leave me in the dirt. But every time you hurt me, the less that I cry. And every time you leave me, the quicker these tears dry. And every time you walk out, the less I love you. Baby, we don't stand a chance. It's sad, but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye.
I'm way too good at goodbye.
I'm way too good at goodbye.
I'm way too good.
I know you're thinking I'm heartless. I know you're thinking I'm cold. I'm just protecting my innocence. I'm just protecting my soul. I'm never gonna let you close to me, even though you mean the most to me, 'cause every time I open up it hurts. So I'm never gonna get too close to you, even when I mean the most to you, in case you go and leave me in the dirt. But every time you hurt me, the less that I cry. And every time you leave me, the quicker these tears dry. And every time you walk out, the less I love you. Baby, we don't stand a chance. It's sad, but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye.
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 No way that you'll see me cry.
No way that you'll see me cry.
I'm way too good at goodbye.
I'm way too good at goodbye.
No, 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 no. And every time you walk out, the less I love you. Baby, we don't stand a chance. It's sad, but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye.
3 weeks at number one then for Sam Smith and Too Good at Goodbyes. And I hope you've enjoyed this Radio 1 Vintage Chart Show. Mark Goodyear, thank you so much for being part of it.
It's an absolute pleasure, Greg. And Annie's next.